Hey Crafters, Lisa here from Fun Stuff Crafts. So glad you could join me today for another Inspiration Friday. So today I'm really excited to share with you a project where I'm going to be using my heat press and I'm going to be using my sublimation printer, and we are going to be making customized ribbons. So give me a second. I am going to join you in Canva and I'm going to show you how I made my design, and then I'm going to show you how to press them. Super easy project. All kinds of customization you guys can be doing. So give me a second and we'll get making. Okay, so we're gonna start this out in Canva, and I do have the paid version and I've already signed on. But this basic design we're going to be doing, you can do on the free version. So what I like to do is I like to go up here and create a design, and I am going to do a custom size, okay, because I want the size to be the same as my ribbon, okay? So I'm using 1.5 inch ribbon, okay, and the paper I'm going to be printing on, whoops, Lisa forgot to change it to inches, so let's go ahead and go back, switched it to inches, and I'm going to be 1.5 inches, and the paper I'm going to be using, I'm just going to be using regular 8.5 by 11 paper. So I'm going to do it that size. That way I know I can fit multiples on. Okay. And so this is a very skinny design. Okay. And then I am going to go ahead and I have already saved my logo. Okay. And so I am going to bring my logo over. And you can see, I'm gonna go ahead and make this bigger so you guys can see it a little bit better, okay? And so I'm gonna bring my logo over. Now you guys, you could add anything onto your ribbon, okay? I just happen to be using my logo because I like putting these on tags when I'm making. I'm using these for items when I'm sewing, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead and center that, okay? So I just want to center it. And I could actually make this bigger. My logo right there is really, really small, okay? So I'm gonna bring it out and I am going to, and see that purple line? That is centering it for me also. And so you can see I've got room on my ribbon on either side, okay? So I am now just going to duplicate this, okay? And so I can just go through here and I can say I can duplicate it, okay? And so now I've got it one more time. Now you guys will notice it thinks I have a background, okay? So I wanna show you a cool trick. And if I go to edit my image, one of the first things that come up is background remover. Now, you guys would say, Lisa, your background's already white, right? But think about if you've got a picture of something that's got something other than white in it, okay? Takes a few minutes, but now my background, and so I'm gonna get rid of that one that we duplicated, and now I wanna show you, I'm gonna duplicate, whoops, I keep grabbing the wrong one. I'm gonna duplicate this again, okay? And now you can see the difference, so I can put them really close together, or I can space them, you know, out a little bit, okay? Now, one thing for my tags that I like to do is I like to fold my tags when I'm doing my sewing, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to flip my image and I'm gonna flip it vertically, okay? So that way when I fold my tags, it says funstuffcrafts.com on both sides of my tag. So let's zoom out a little bit here so you guys can kind of see what that's gonna look like on the ribbon, okay? So once I have that kind of figured out where I want my that to go, okay? I can take both of these designs, okay? And I can group them together. And now what I can do is I can just duplicate. Bring down another one here. And I like to have enough spacing in there, you guys, so that I've got room to sew my edges, okay? And then I'm just going to duplicate again. And I'm gonna bring that down. So this is as easy as it is doing the designs, you guys. And you can see I've got room for a little bit more, so I'm going to go ahead and just keep duplicating. Okay, so think about all the options you guys can do with this type of thing. I was talking with Michael, my son's girlfriend, yesterday, and I was giving her the idea of, what about at Christmas time? Doing your ribbons so that you don't have to use tags, right? Do up some ribbons that have everybody's names on them. Right. And so that way you could just have ribbons to tie around your presents. The other one, I see a lot of people, cheerleading bows. You know, you could customize these with your high school logo on them. You can do all kinds of different things. The key here, you guys, and I'm just playing with it right now just to get the most out of mine. The key to this whole thing, you guys, is 100% polyester ribbon. As long as you've got that, you're ready to go. Okay, so all I'm going to do now is I like to I'm going to name mine, so logo ribbon. Okay, and then I'm going to download it. I always download mine as a PNG, so it's a picture. Okay, and then I'm just going to go ahead and download it. Now I'm using my MacBook Pro. So whatever type of computer you have, and then there is my design, okay? It is all ready to go, okay? So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna go up to File, and I'm gonna go to Print, and I've already got my sublimation printer set up, okay? And so I'm gonna ask this to go to my sublimation printer. Now, I will tell you guys, you could do multiples here. So if I were to say I want to get two on one page, okay? It will do two going that way. I'm gonna try to reverse it and see, there I am. I'm gonna be able to print two. Let's see if it's not gonna let me do the three. So at least I can get two prints of my design off of this one sheet of paper. So I'm gonna send this over to the printer, and I'm gonna meet you back over at my printer and my heat press, and we're gonna get this pressed. So I'm gonna go ahead and just hit print, and it is going to be ready to go. Okay, so I got my print off of my printer, and I already cut it in half, okay? So we've got our print off. I did it on the A sub paper using my Epson printer that's already converted with Cosmo ink. I love my Cosmo ink. And I am gonna now apply this to the ribbon, okay? So I picked up this satin ribbon at Hobby Lobby. Okay, and like I said, when we were in Canva, this is 1.5 inches, okay? So did the design to fit the ribbon. So if you guys buy a different size ribbon, like I also picked up this ribbon that's 7/8 inches. So I could do another design and do it on this. So it really just depends on what size ribbon you guys wanna do, okay? And here is what we're going to end up with, and I hope you guys can see that the colors are just incredible how this comes out. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to take our ribbon, but before we do that, I do have the heat press coming up to heat right now, 400 degrees for 45 seconds. You guys, this is super quick. Okay, so just think, I could put a whole bed of ribbon on here and do it all at once. I'm only going to do one sheet just to show you guys how it all comes together. Okay, so I have my my printout, and I cut it out. Ribbon has got two sides. Okay, so there's this shiny side, and you can kind of see it in the light, and then there's more of a dull side. We always want to sublimate on the shiny side. Okay, so I'm going to tape it down onto my paper. Now, ghosting is something you guys will hear about in sublimation. And what ghosting is ghosting is whenever your substrate, being ribbon in this case, shifts, okay, it'll cause a shadow. And that shadow is what they call ghosting, okay? So really important, this is a step you don't want to miss. And we want to tape down our ribbon. Okay, so I'm gonna just tape it down, and I don't have to do the whole thing. I just don't want it to move once I put it on the press, okay? Now, I'm gonna switch over on this side so you can see my press a little bit more. I'm using my Tessie 15 by 15 heat press. Whatever size you guys have will work. Just make sure that's what size your image is, okay? So I have got a piece of butcher paper down. We call this blowout paper, okay? Blowout paper is needed because your ink could seep through. So let me show you what happens if you forget your blowout paper, which Lisa's done before. Look at that. I did not have my blowout paper. Really important that you want to have your blowout paper in place, okay? These are just the standard mats that came with my heat press, okay? So I am going to put my first sheet of blowout paper down. I'm going to take my design with my design facing down, okay? My ribbon is right here, you guys. My design is facing down. I'm going to put that right there. I've got another piece of blowout paper. I would suggest you never use your blowout paper more than once, okay? Because even the little bit of ink that could transfer to your blowout paper could in turn transfer to your next image. So I've got this nice big roll of butcher paper that I use. I can tear off and I can do it anytime that I need it. So I go through lots of butcher paper. Okay, we're almost up to heat. Let's talk about some other ideas. When we were in Canva, I gave you guys a couple ideas of what you guys could do with these ribbons. But think about lanyards. The little store that I sell some of my stuff at-ish, Pacific Northwest downtown, is always asking me for lanyards. People are looking for customized things, okay? Put your name on it, put a business name on it, okay? We talked about cheer bows. That is a really big thing. I love the idea about the Christmas presents. Forget about writing tags, okay, for Christmas presents. Why not just do ribbon with your kids' names on it? So many different things. But look past ribbon, you guys. This opens up the world to supplementing on 100% polyester. I did it a couple weeks ago for a baby blanket, you know, and I did it on a light pink. White is always best. When you're talking about ribbon here, you know, you could go with your light colors. You could go with a pale yellow, a pale pink, a pale blue. White definitely is going to give you the best color when we're dealing with anything that you supplement on because it shows up so much better. Okay, let's go back and check our time. We are almost there. What I want to show you before we get there is this is an idea of a tag. See, it's just a little tag that I'm doing. This original tags I did, I didn't put my logo on. It just says Fun Stuff Crafts. Might be hard to read there, but just looks professional. Just a homemade tag. So think about doing something like that if you guys are a sewer. Made by Grandma. I could have put homemade by Lisa. I just decided to do my logo because I do a lot of sewing and different things and I take it down to our little store downtown. So I thought the tags would be great. I had ordered some offline. I was going to do it again. And I thought, Lisa, that's crazy. Make your own. So that's what we're doing here. Okay. So I am almost here. We are at 377. We're going to wait till it gets there and then we'll engage it right away. Okay. Okay, you guys. So I thought I might bring you a little bit closer for the big reveal. Okay. So the heat press just went off. It's a little hot. Okay. So we are going to take our ribbon off and let us just check out and see what this looks like. Look how beautiful that turned out, you guys. The colors are just absolutely great. Still got a little bit of tape on there, but the colors just turned out great. I also wanted to show you guys, I did put together another bag a little bit closer with one of our tags we made, okay? And because I have done two batches of these tags now. So this is just an idea of how that really looks professional. And this is the reason why, you guys, I do the tag on both sides. So when I flip it over, you can see Fun Stuff Crafts on both sides. So I'll make sure I give you another close-up view of this. I sure hope you enjoyed this Inspiration Friday. Make sure you give it a thumbs up, and we'll see you next week.